Alright, I also have one more thing I want to share with you guys. Kevin? Alright, you're probably wondering what's with the matching t-shirts, right? Just a little bit? Alright, actually it's for my work, actually. I'm working on as you know by now, Stockton probably is a bad rap. I'm not sure if any of you have heard this. Forbes has named Stockton the most miserable city in the United States. And number one in murder rates in California. And they say no one cares about Stockton. Well, I say wrong. Arthur. Project Yes. Yes stands for Youth Empowering Stockton. So basically, this program is designed to basically give the people of Stockton a voice through the youth researchers like myself. Kevin's not a youth researcher, but he...
I'm just here for support.
Anyway, so basically Project Yes goes into the low-income and the homeless areas of Stockton, which the majority of these two types of people would be in the downtown area, which is by the waterfront, which should not be. There should be none of that in the city at all. So anyway, what Project Yes was started a year ago, and it's been in the works since. We're partnered with 8 organizations, including the University of Pacific at the moment. So they're the ones who give us our funding. So they're the ones who pay us. Anyway, but that's not why I do the project. I'm doing it because I want to get my city cleaned up. I want to put our house back in order. So that's why I'm part of this. Not because of the money, not because it's a job. Because I genuinely care about my city. Anyway, there's 4 phases of the project. Phase 1 is what we're doing right now. And it's going into the field, collecting the data throughout the whole area of downtown. Right now, we're about halfway done with our field work research. So about Wednesday or Thursday, we should be done. Phase 2 is where we're going to be interviewing people throughout the whole community, not just in the downtown area, but north side, south side, east side, west side, and central, and even those out of town, like in Lodi, for crying out loud. We want to get everyone's voices, and the reason why we're doing this project is to give these people a voice. These people who are low income, homeless, they don't have a voice in the city government. All they did, all the police, the fire department, all of them, they just brush them aside like second-rate citizens. It's not right. I've seen it go on all my life. That has been happening to me all my life, too. I am sick of it. That's why I'm doing it. I don't want to see this happen anymore to the next generation, the next youth that's going to step up, the next teenagers. These children right now, they're going to be the next generation high schoolers in a few years. They don't need to be treated like second-rate citizens just because... Oh, you don't live in Brookside. You're not rich enough. That's not right. I never did like it. It hurts. It hurts so much in here. We're supposed to live in a democracy. The people don't have a voice too much, and these people don't have a voice. So this is what the project's for. They just brush them off. So that's why we're doing this. Anyway, sorry, I got a little off on there. Phase 3. Phase 3 of the project is also when we're going to be going through our findings, and we're going to be proposing programs to bring to the city government. You know, we're talking with the people, see what they want too. You know, we're not just going to propose it to ourselves. We're going to talk with the people. You know, get the community involved in it, see what they want to do. Phase 4 is where we're going to be putting the programs into action. Basically, I just want to do this presentation mainly to show people, to say that not all of Stockton's bad. Everyone, people care in the city. And that's just all I wanted to say about this. That's all. That, you know, and that, tell everyone about this project. Please tell them we're trying to clean up our city. We've told Forbes, we're, you know, we don't appreciate what Forbes said, but that's just, you know, that's their opinion, you know. That's fine. They're entitled to their opinion, I guess. Anyway, I just wanted to say, thank you for listening. That's all.